cataractcoach.com. Cataract and a history of amblyopia. So which eye gets cataract surgery first and why? And what are the additional risks with monocular patients? So show the video 2x normal speed in the background. Let's talk about this patient. Lifelong history of right eye amblyopia. So even 10 years ago, the right eye had a best corrected visual acuity of 20 out of 200. 10 years ago, the left eye had a best corrected acuity of 20/20. The right eye is about a plus 8 prescription for the full distance correction. The left eye is about a plus 3. So about 5 diopters of anisometropia. When we do the lens calculations, the right eye requires a 32 diopter IOL for plano, and the left eye requires a 24.5 diopter IOL for the same plano outcome. This patient certainly has a history of anisometropic amblyopia in that right eye. The patient currently wears spectacles with the plus 3 RX in both eyes, so it's the left eye being corrected and the right eye is just receiving a balanced RX. Now look at the OCT images there. The patient has an epi-retinal membrane with some degree of macular pucker in the left eye. So that may play a role too in the post-op period. The right eye has a normal macula. So which eye has cataract surgery first? What do you recommend for the patient? I recommend the left eye first. The ERM and the pucker is relatively modest, and I think just doing the cataract surgery will restore the patient's vision to a very acceptable level. When you fix the left eye, the patient should recover excellent visual acuity and will be very happy from it. Then when you say, okay, we can try the right eye, the patient will say, yes, doctor, please fix the right eye. And you'll say, well, I don't know if it'll actually see any better. I'll fix it. I'll put in the 32 diopter lens. It'll probably still be 20 out of 200. And the patient will say, that's okay, doctor. Please just try your best. If, however, let's say you did the right eye cataract surgery first. You do the right eye and the surgery goes beautifully and the patient ends up with 20/200 vision because that's limited by the amblyopia, even with a perfect plano outcome. The patient then is not going to understand the benefit of the cataract surgery and will then be very cautious and hesitant even about doing cataract surgery of the other eye, of the good eye. And this patient then may wait until that good eye, the left eye in this case, ends up having a very dense, advanced, mature cataract. And that makes it more challenging for everyone. So in this situation, I recommend doing the cataract surgery in this left eye first. Here you see the 24.5 diopter IOL being implanted. It goes in beautifully. This case ends up great. In the post-op period, we're cautious, making sure we give the patient topical steroids and NSAIDs in order to prevent any macular edema, which is more likely in the presence of that ERM and macular pucker. Fortunately, the patient did beautifully. She ended up with 20/20 visual acuity and just has some very mild dysphotopsias that she notes in her macula due to the ERM, but not bothered at all by it. We did the patient's other eye, as you'd expect, and the right eye achieved a plano outcome and 20 out of 200 vision limited by the amblyopia. So definitely there are more risks involved in a patient like this who's relatively monocular. And my take-home lesson to you is, if they need to see better, you need to fix the non-amblyopic eye first. And the patient will have the best outcome with that and the best improvement in visual acuity. Then in the future, afterwards, you can do the amblyopic eye and the patient will understand the limitations. Thanks for watching. And check out cataractcoach.com for the full teaching website, all organized by categories and indexed with a great search engine too.